While BIM is now massively used for its ability to design buildings in 3D, CAD in DWG format remains the cornerstone for creating more detailed 2D technical drawings. The BIM features in ARES Commander aim at bridging the gap between the CAD and BIM users. With ARES Commander, users can easily import Revit and IFC files and automatically generate all the floor plans, sections, and elevations before eventually drawing more details on top. This year, we've expanded these capabilities with new features to enhance the drawing automation. Let's take a closer look.
In previous versions of ARES Commander, we introduced the BIM Drawings features to automate the creation of 2D drawings in DWG format, which stay in sync with Revit or IFC projects. This year, we extended these capabilities one step further with these new features you see highlighted in the BIM ribbon. Before diving into each of these features, let's review the BIMAUTOALL command and BIM Drawings automation. In the BIM Navigator, we can see we have imported a Revit file, which is the hotel we see in the Model tab. ARES Commander can import both Revit and IFC files. We have configured a BIM filter to isolate only the objects we want to see in our drawings. In the BIM Navigator, we can also see all the floor plans, sections, and elevations that were generated by ARES from the BIM model. Such drawings can be created manually from the features we find in the ribbon. But to save time, we used BIM Drawings automation instead. The BIMAUTOALL command successively runs all the steps required to create the floor plans, sections, and elevations. And also automatically creates sheets, dimensions, and labels. After a few minutes, we obtain all the drawings we see now in the BIM Navigator. And we can use the CAD features to continue our projects by working on top of them. This year, ARES Commander is introducing new refinements to the BIM Drawings automation features. With the help of AI, the labels are automatically positioned to avoid overlapping other entities during the drawing production process. Alternatively, we find in the ribbon a new feature to adjust labels manually if desired. In addition to the controls that make them easier to manipulate, labels have also evolved aesthetically. Most importantly, if the original model is updated, all changes made by the user will be preserved. Another enhancement is the introduction of the new split drawing function, which enables the division of drawings into multiple sheets. This feature becomes essential when a drawing, scaled to a specific size, exceeds the space constraints of a single sheet. A third improvement is the BIM Dimension Chain command, which can operate either manually or automatically. This feature now supports the creation of dimension chains for vertical or horizontal elements. There are also new options that automatically prevent text overlap if elements are too close together. From BIM Dimension Style, you can configure different types of dimension chains, and even choose specific BIM elements for each dimension chain. At the same time, you can determine what the reference points will be for each case. Each dimension chain style can even have a specific dimension style assigned to it. Next, let's talk about the new Multiview Blocks. You can find this feature under the name BIM Geometry Edit. By default, ARES Commander takes the 2D symbol saved in the BIM object. Such symbols are frequently provided in Revit, but in IFC, they are often missing. Even in this example, imported from Revit, we see that the door is appearing as both open and closed. Of course, displaying two different states at the same time isn't correct. We are currently working with level 4 of the building, but the fact is that these doors are repeated on all levels of the building. The BIM Geometry Edit command will allow us to correct the 2D representation of the door. To do this, we must go to the main drawing, where we will insert the BIM model. To find the level 4 door more easily, we are going to create a filter that includes only the level that interests us. We switch to a wireframe visual style. We choose the BIM Geometry Edit command and select the door. We enter something that's similar to a block editor, except it is specialized in multiview blocks of the BIM model. We use Remove User Blocks to free elements from the multiview block so we can modify or delete them, as in this example. Now we insert the door block. For this, we can use some of the examples we have in the tool palette. We use the Add User Blocks command to make the new 2D block part of the BIM model representation. Note that the block turns green after validation. We save the changes. In this list, we see that the drawings marked with this small symbol need to be updated. So we do a right-click and choose Refresh. We see the doors appear as expected, and, being dynamic blocks, we gained the possibility to change their opening side if needed. Let's take a look at the new Detail Drawings feature, which you can find here in the ribbon. We can use this function to create an additional drawing by enlarging a specific part of our original drawing. The program asks us to set the scale at which the new drawing will be referenced. We assign a name to the tag and see how it was created in the Details section of the BIM Navigator. Now we can open it and add detailed information about this area using traditional CAD functions. This type of element can be applied both in plan views and in section and elevation views. When we create the BIM project in ARES Commander, automatic drawings are generated and grouped around the main DWG through sheet set drawings. Each new drawing holds at least one scaled view of the building. We can work with any of these drawings as if it were a standard ARES Commander DWG drawing. We can easily incorporate furniture, thanks to the extensive library of dynamic blocks found in the tool palette. We can also place sanitary fixtures. Next, let's imagine that we define the location of lights, switches, and power outlets in the rooms of this hotel. Now, we would like to present this idea to the client to get their opinion on it. We don't want to share the entire project. We only need to share the specific drawing where we have incorporated this room information. To do this, we can upload the drawing to the cloud. And generate a view-only link. At the same time, we can grant editor status to our colleagues who are handling the installations, so that they can review the project and make comments on it. Our client accesses the view-only link, and because they have created a free Graebert account, they can comment on the drawing. The client raises the issue that the current electrical installation does not accommodate the possibility of having rooms with separate beds. Using the markup features, the client adds a photo and a comment to better explain their point of view. In this case, our colleague who handles the interior design of the rooms presents a practical solution to this problem, so that the client can easily switch between one option and another, depending on how the hotel's needs evolve. To learn more about the BIM features of ARES Commander, please explore our wide range of videos showcasing the evolution of these features.